Hi folks, Mick here. You're watching another episode of the Wild Guide to Wild Edibles and Herbs. And for this herb, you're going to need one of these. So, in this episode, we're looking for burdock or Arctium lapa. Now, it's native to Europe and northern part of Asia. And you know, the Asian countries swear by it, saying it's great for ailments and things like that. Grows almost anywhere. Fields, woods, hedges, you know, and there was no poisonous lookalikes. Now, it typically grows between 3 to 4 feet tall, flowers in between July and October, and the flowers are like a little velcro ball. They stick to your claws, and that's how they spread the seeds about. Ingenious thinking, eh? Just finding some because we've had a very, very dry season. And trying to find some is pretty difficult at the moment. Now, the taproot is a tuber, and that's the part of the plant that we want. Now, this plant does wonders. It can help you to treat sore throat, cold, arthritis, rheumatism. It can help treat skin conditions, eczema, psoriasis. It's a diuretic and a diaphoretic, helping you sweat. Think I had some already. But it's also an aphrodisiac, helping you with your sexual desire. Whoa. It's a blood purifier, antioxidant, and they also say that can help treat some cancers. Bingo. Found some. Doesn't look very good, sample mind. Right, so this is one of the leaves. The leaves are usually bigger than this. There's a few little ones dotted around there. You can eat the leaf, but the leaf is very, very bitter. Very bitter indeed. Now, it's an anti-scorbutic, making great for boils and scurvy. It contains vitamin C, vitamins E, folic acid, riboflavin, high concentrations of potassium, magnesium, calcium, selenium, and phosphorus, rich in fibres, a small amount of zinc, and it's very high in iron. Very high. So what we're going to do is we're going to dig here and see if we can get a decent root out. Yeah, that's what I want. One of these. There's a few more kicking around. I want to see if I can click them as well. Another one. So I'm going to get these cleaned up down the river and then show you what I want to do with them. Ooh. Right then, folks. This bit should be fine. That bit, I don't know. So you're supposed to get the first year root, like the first year plant, because the root turns a little bit woody. But I think we can still use this, yep. Should be able to. Now I see as China use this, they've used it for millennium, making their tea, things like that. You know, herbal medicinal tea. But it's great complement with pork. So I've got a nice piece of pork shoulder. I'm going to cook this up along with the shoulder of pork, and we're going to have some hawthorn and yarrow tea. Oh yes. Got the chopping board. I'm going to see if I can clean this up. You can actually buy this in health stores. So right, so let's try some of this. Tastes like sweet potato, maybe. This is woody. Yeah, it's no good to me when it's like that. I'll try this bit there. Yeah, this bit's better. Much better. I'm going to screw up the skin over here. Now, as it says, there is no poisonous lookalikes. So what? I'll forage over here till your heart's content. Now I'm going to add the pieces of burdock root, coat them up with it. Well, I think that's done. We'll leave it cool there. I'm going to get the kettle on. Lovely. Still has that apple, that potato taste. It's nice. Well. Excuse me. Another successful cooking with their wide edibles. So I'm going to save you the torment of me, you having to watch me eat this. So I'm going to sign off now, folks. Remember, it's out there. You just got to go out and find it. So thanks for watching, folks. There'll be another one coming up very soon. My name's Mick and I'm a 12th Sagittarian. Don't dream it, live it. See you later, folks.